My name is Jóhann Gunnarsson. I'm a son of farmers who lived in the south of Iceland. After school, I married rather early and never finished my university education, but I got into a very interesting job with IBM, which I enjoyed very much for 23 years. Then I got into the University of Iceland Computing Center, and after that I was working as a consultant for the government of Iceland. So my life has been very much in computers and in the information technology field, which never left one in peace. There was always some new things happening, and very, very interesting all the time. So I think I've had a very good life. We also have had four kids, which was very good, and it's good to have when you're old, to have kids to take care of you. Well, that's it more or less.
So in so many interviews with your son and interviews that I was able to do with him, he mentioned you as a major influence on him, musically and as a father. And I know you played in a brass band, and you were a music fan yourself and a musician. Can you tell me where that love for music came from?
Well, I think it comes from my father. He was an amateur musician, loved singing, and played the violin when young, which was not very common in Iceland at that time. And then when I was about 10, he bought a reed organ, which he intended us brothers to learn to play. My younger brother did that a little bit, I didn't quite get it. And that organ actually is in Johann's studio in Berlin now. So he inherited that from his grandfather.
Wow. Do you know, did he use that in any of his recordings?
He did, yes. Yeah. I don't know exactly where, but I know that he made some recordings. And also, while he was in Iceland, he used it, he had it in his studio in Reykjavik as well.
So I know in addition to playing music, you've actually built your own instruments.
Yes.
And when did you start building them? And
well, I'll tell you when I got the idea. That was many years ago, during the years from between 1965 and 70. I was quite often in London, England, for extended periods, maybe, and for weeks at least. And I attended concerts a lot. And there was one time I heard a symphony for organ by Vítor.
Okay.
Which fascinated me so that I have never been the same after that. And I started thinking about organs and looking a little bit at how they are made, and I saw that it might be possible to build an organ myself.
Yeah.
So then I waited, and in 2011, when we both had settled down and were not working anymore, my wife and I, and were living in Hveragerði in a very nice house, I said to myself, now it's now or never to start.
Wow, that's amazing. So you didn't actually start building instruments until you retired?
No.
And what was it about that performance that moved you so much? To make you, like, and to plant that seed that 30 years later you took action?
Well, the organ is a magnificent instrument. And to hear what one guy could get out of that.
Yes.
And this symphony by Vítor is really a masterpiece. It's magnificent. And I tried to get a record, and there was only one bit of it that was available on records at that time. Later, a German guy made a recording, but it's just magnificent, you know, the organ. I've been fascinated with organs since then.
So first of all, tell me about the organ you played today, the hand organ.
Yeah, well, that is a German design, designed for amateurs to build. It's a bit complicated. There are a lot of small pieces in it. I did it all myself, except I had to buy the relays, of course, for the electronics and the electronic part. I got that from Germany too.
Yes.
And then, of course, there are a lot of help on the internet from people who have done this before. And there is a community about these street organs. So I've benefited a lot from that, and then also I made another one, a more primitive one, which is according to an English design. They both play 20 notes, but this one is going to be, when it's finished, because it's not finished, I just put it together and made it into a playable state. But there is a lot of work still to be made on it.
It's a work in progress.
Yes, it is.
When you were building the instruments, I guess this happened later, you know, if you started in 2011.
Yeah.
Did Jóhann, like have any involvement? Like, did you?
Yeah, he played the organ and tested the first organ, and he liked it very much. And it was always his intention to use it for recordings, but that unfortunately did not.
Yeah.
He didn't make it, but he liked the sound of it, and he was a kind of an organ fan as well.
When he was growing up, was he always curious and tinkering around with stuff?
Well, he got very early into music. He started when he was about 10, we went to France and lived in France for 3 years, and he learned to play the trombone in the school that he attended, which was the American school in Paris.
Mm-hmm.
And then upon returning home, he continued playing the trombone, but very soon got into electronics and synthesizers and those kind of things. And from then on, there was no return. That was the only thing he was interested in.
He found his passion.
Oh yes, certainly.
Growing up, you mentioned after you moved back from France and he had discovered music, you know, and was playing the trombone, then he got into like synthesizers and started being in kind of punk rock bands or rock bands. His first band, Daisy Hill Puppy Farm,
yeah,
that was like 85-ish, he was maybe 15?
Yeah.
Would they practice at the house?
No. No, they had some garage, I think, where they practiced, yes.
Yeah. What was it like then? Like, was he bringing home music? Would you hear what he was doing?
he was not very open about that. It was different. This was rock, and we were not much into rock. His mother and I. But no, he was doing that really on his own.
Yeah, I mean, and then the Kitchen Motors Collective was really a remarkable kind of think tank of interdisciplinary artists of all types and all kinds of music.
Yes.
And that is certainly a big part of his legacy that people, might not realize how diverse his musical tastes were and how I think he really planted a lot of seeds for people to explore and be open to different kinds of sounds.
Oh yeah, he certainly did that, but he was not alone in Kitchen Motors, as you know.
Yes.
There were other people working with him in that time.
So on October 27th, there was a memorial concert for Jóhann held at IDNO here in Reykjavik, and many artists in this community joined together to pay tribute to Jóhann and performed his music, and you performed a piece on your street organ. And for you at that time, what was that experience like for you?
It was wonderful. I really appreciate the opportunity, first of all, to help construct some of his memories and relive memories about him, but also to have the opportunity to play with professional people who really know how to make music.
Can you describe, like, today playing Cambridge 1963 from A Theory of Everything, and you were playing it on the street organ with a really young string quartet?
Yes.
What is it like playing Johann's melodies with these really young kids?
Well, it's inspiring, and it was interesting to hear how the performance improved. We made it three or four times, and the last recording was definitely by far the best.
I thought so too. Like after the second take, I think there was a feeling like, should we wrap? And one of the kids was like, no, let's do one more. And then I think they nailed it.
It was worth it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is there anything else you'd like to say about Jóhann?
Well, he was our youngest kid, and he will be greatly missed. That is the main thing, but we are lucky to have three daughters older than him, and they are very loving, very good to us, and take good care of us old people. So losing him was a serious thing, but we are really lucky that he was not our only kid, because I think that would be really terrible to lose one's only kid.
Yes.
I cannot imagine that. We will, as I say, there's now several months, and we have been in sorrow, but it is important, and it's nice to hear hear and feel how people all around the world have loved him and his music, and his music will certainly live, and there is a lot of people who are helping to do that, you amongst others on your station, which is greatly appreciated.
Yeah, KEXP will do everything we can to uphold his legacy and to make sure new music lovers hear his music.
Yeah.
Because it's amazing.
Thank you very much for that. That's really appreciated.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Discover new music at listener-powered KEXP.org.